Mrs. Arundhati Bhattacharya is by far the prima donna of not just Indian banking, but perhaps the Indian business scene. Normally, when a person like her retires, she would have had confrontations with promoters in her last 3 years, confrontations with the government on what things like food credit or farm loan waivers. She would have had confrontation with the regulator on issues like provisioning. But unanimously, when she retired, everyone was almost wanting her to stay on for a bit more. Mrs. Bhattacharya, thank you very much for sparing time. You know, that was my first question when you were retiring. You really were in a confrontationist mode with several people, and yet everyone wanted you to stay. How do you manage confrontation and yet perhaps cooperation?
I think, you know, it's a question of trying to give a solution rather than merely pointing out the problems. Mm. And again, it's the glass half full and glass half empty syndrome. When I try to say something which I believe is rational and reasonable, I try to put it in those terms, that this is really the reasonable way of going about it. And I also try to give a solution, the alternative, what could be done instead of this. And therefore, you know, because it comes with a constructive kind of a, from a constructive kind of a mindset, I think people don't really feel bad about being told something. You know, I have really and truly tried to propagate collaboration. So whether it be on the 18th floor of the bank or whether it be within the various silos of the bank, within the group, and even with the industry. Today, if you see, you know, there is much more talk within the industry as to how we take things forward. In fact, I was told...
I think that's to your credit.
No, but I was told, you know, somebody in Delhi told me that y'all now have formed the Gulabi gang. Because, you know, there was Chanda and there was Shikha. And that point of time, you know, Mrs. Panse was there. And then Usha came in. So the fact of the matter is, you know, I think we get along much better. We talk much more. We try, and especially, you know, in respect of those accounts where people are playing one against the other. Yes. They will come and tell me, you know, that bank has given me this facility, you are not giving me. So they can't do that anymore. I simply pick up the phone in front of the person and ask, did you give this? Mm-hmm. And why did you? So, you know, so to that extent, I think, you know, even collaboration in the within the industry, we've been able to increase. Okay. And that, I think, is something that is that people do recognize and people okay. appreciate.
Well, therefore, what next? Where do we see you? You have kept that a secret.
See, actually speaking, I don't know myself. Okay. I think what I'll try to do is to do a portfolio of activities, maybe do some amount of speaking, which, you know, in areas where, do more deep dives in them, which I have not had a chance of doing. And of course, you know, take up a few board positions. So I don't really want to get locked in into a 10 to 5 unless it's something really, really exciting. Okay. I'm not ruling that out either, but at this point of time, you know, I'm really looking at a bunch of things and trying to gauge. Okay. To tell you the truth, you know, it is impossible to do these things while you are in the bank. The hours are such, you just do not have time to look around and find out what you're going to do.
Oh, yes. I know. I saw your ambition to do even a PhD.
Yes, that's also there.
But, you know, when you speak of board positions, have you ever felt that you would have been so much better off, wealthier off, if you had a private sector position?
See, at the end of the day, nobody was stopping me from leaving. Mm. Anybody who comes with a grouse of this nature to me, I tell them very clearly, you are here on your own volition. I stayed out of my own volition. Okay. Yes, some once in a while you may have a regret, but then, you know, that is my doing. It is nobody else's doing. I could have left whenever, you know, if I really wanted to put that as a priority, I could have left at any point of time.
Okay. Actually, that brings me to the meat of the conversation I wanted to have with you. What would be your golden bullet for public sector banks? I am not trying to say that, you know, there have been private sector banks also which have similar problems because of the turn in the economy. But still, public sector banks have a problem in the sense of the average NPL being much higher. What's your golden bullet suggestion?
See, it's very difficult to compress it all into one bullet.
Sure.
You know, there have to be a number of initiatives. And I think one reason why SBI has consistently done better is because
First thing is, SBI's board has always had some very good people. Again, reason for that is that we always had four people representing the minority shareholders. Now, these four people were all chosen for their expertise, okay? Not only in respect of the theory piece, but also in respect of their execution piece. And these four people have always given very good support to the various things that SBI has been able to do. So first and foremost, I think it's a question of strengthening the board. Any good thing must emanate from the top. It doesn't go from bottom up, you know, it has to be top down. So that I think the government is already looking at, but that is something that really needs still a lot of work on. For instance, while we have some very good people on our board in SBI, there are still vacancies. I think four vacancies or six vacancies were there.
So first set the board right is your
set
suggestion.
The board right, get the right people in and give them a variety of experience from risk, experience from HR, experience in execution of projects, experience in IT. So there are various pieces, you know, which need to be there. So I think that is very, very important.
You know, even now, public sector banks are obviously reined behind, probably because of lack of capital. I mean, is this capital argument right? Or is it that there is no demand for loans?
See, immediately if some very good projects come, they will not lack for finance.
Okay?
Finance is really not a problem. But to what extent? Today, the public sector banks are growing at, say, 4, 5, 6%. There will not be a problem till it goes up to, say, about 12%. Subsequent to that, you do need capital.
Okay.
So it is not right to say I don't need growth capital at all. If the economy is growing well, I absolutely need growth capital. But if it is growing at a very...
But today, do you think it is a demand issue that
today I think
growth
is
not there?
No. Today it is definitely a demand issue. Today it is definitely a demand
issue.
So
even if the public sector banks had, you know, 14% or 13% CAR...
Absolutely. This may not be true for the smaller public sector banks or for all of the public sector banks, but it is true for a large number of them. And even today, if you have a project, you know, that needs 20,000 crores of financing, it will get done very, very quickly if the project is a good
bankable
one. Yeah, if it is a good one.
Okay, I'm going to make it rapid fire. Calcutta or Mumbai? Hindi films or English films? Football or cricket?